Sid, just wondering,
is there such thing as insanity among penguins?
I don't know about concern. I mean, he's a world-class player, and, you know, they're adding them to their team. So you look how dangerous he is, and for even missing the amount of time he did, he looked pretty good out there. And fortunately, we were able to stay out of the box. You know how dangerous his shot is and what that brings to a power play. So, I think we weren't sure what was going to happen. I think we just tried to worry about us, but it's hard not to know if he's out there and be aware of that.
I try to avoid a definition of insanity or derangement. I don't mean that a penguin might believe he or she is Lenin, Napoleon Bonaparte.
But could they just go crazy because they've had enough of their colony?
I think just nerves, excited. It's not easy, and having gone through a couple of those, early on, 20 and 21 years old playing in the finals, I think you have more of an appreciation for it now, and just love the opportunity to be able to get back.
These penguins are all heading to the open water to the right. But one of them caught our eye, the one in the center. He would neither go towards the feeding grounds at the edge of the ice, nor return to the colony. Shortly afterwards, we saw him heading straight towards the mountains, some 70 kilometers away. Dr. Ainley explained that even if he caught him and brought him back to the colony, he would immediately head right back for the mountains. But why? One of these disoriented or deranged penguins showed up at the New Harbor diving camp, already some 80 kilometers away from where it should be. The rules for the humans are: do not disturb or hold up the penguin. Stand still and let him go on his way. And here, he's heading off into the interior of the vast continent. With 5,000 kilometers ahead of him, he's heading towards certain death.